like to begin. This is a story about a once upon. Oh, I didn't tell you.
This is a story about not being told.
Gives you a little more leeway for creativity. Once upon a time, there was a good farmer. Right next door, however, lived a bad farmer. One day, just after dawn, what happened? Who would like to begin?
Just after dawn, the good farmer awoke to the sound of crowing right at the foot of his bed.
Grumpily, he put his feet on the floor and stood, staring at the wretched, wretched bird. That's when he heard the bell
blow. I don't know what sound that makes. From across the field, but coming closer.
Across the field, coming ever closer to his bedroom window. A terrible tummy ache, it sounded like it had. Like a bear who had eaten too many sour apples.
Which, of course, it had. Proceeded to deposit on the farmer's bed.
The farmer had no idea what to do with such a large and fearsome toothy beast. So he began to beat the rooster with no mercy. Rooster made all sorts of roosters being beaten noises. It was most displeased. That's not fair at all. And it turned its baleful gaze on the toothsome beast at the window.
Window?
Meanwhile, at the evil farmer's cottage. As you may have guessed, that was his. So he sat at his table drinking his coffee with his pet otter by his side.
Good boy. We won't be. We're brothers.
Now the good farmer, he farmed fine things like vegetables, wheat, all the good things which grow in the earth. The evil farmer, he focused his energies on furry beasts. Some fearsome, like the bear. Some playful and energetic, like the dark otter. And here we have the crux of the quarrel. Plants versus animals. Plants are better. No, beasts are better. This was what brought the two nearly to blows whenever they should meet. Nearly to fist. Whatever they should need.
fine, because the beasts would, of course, run into the good farmer's field and eat his crops. So the good farmer was defending his lemons.
Forever mine.
And the bad farmer would wrestle his bears and otters back.
Come on, come on. You're a good bear.
Else they deposit apples in his bowl. And they were at a standstill. An impact. Until.
Until the two of them found what they thought might be a solution. The problem was that they both farmed open land. There was nothing to keep the plants from wandering across and eating all of the evil farmer's animals. Why, what they might need to do is step out into the afternoon sun with appropriate head covering for protection and convenient use of props and set to work building a wall with whatever and whomever came to hand.
Of course, this was long and arduous and very boring work, so they hired dancers.
Entertain us while we work, they cry.
Entertain us!
With dance and with song. Are you versatile dancers? Can you sing for us?
Excellent! This is the night.
And indeed, long through the afternoon and into the night toiled the two. Until that evening they found they had built a great wall. Neither could see the other, nor indeed did they have energy left to argue. In this case, good fences made for very good, tired and docile neighbors.
Also an excellent place to hang your laundry.